Hello, my name is Warren Cox, and I'm an undergraduate student at the University of Texas at Dallas, involved in the geoscience department. And I'm here to bore you with a story of soil. Because who would care about how the mud caked onto the bottom of your shoe formed? To many, soil is as dull as dirt. But in fact, soil is a complex and intriguing collection of animal, vegetable, and mineral that houses hundreds of life forms and is essential to us. Soil not only allows farmers to grow crops to feed us, but also it nurtures the environment we all want to protect. Despite this, soil is one of our most misused resources, with 36 billion tons of soil lost every year. That is over 4 tons for each person on Earth.
So how much is 36 billion tons of soil? Well, for reference, right here is about 1 ton of soil. Now imagine this much soil times 4 is lost for every person every year because of poor practices.
Soil is lost in 2 main ways, erosion and being buried under asphalt or concrete during human development. These losses can be replaced, but it can take 500 to 1,000 years for 1 inch of soil to form. It is critical that we learn a bit more about soil if we are to preserve this natural resource. So what is soil? It is much more than just the top layer of pebbles and sands and clay that we walk on. Soil is a complex system of sediments, biota, water, and air. Sediments are eroded from rock and develop slowly into soil. This process of soil formation is called pediogenesis. The story of soil can be explained by a funny acronym CLORPT. It all begins with P, or parent rock. The parent rock will break down in place or be transported as clay and sand to provide the body of the soil. Rock breakdown is controlled by CL for climate, which provides water that infiltrates the broken down rock or sediment. Additionally, water brings microscopic life to the soil formation party. O, or organisms, flourish in this environment, providing nutrients and accelerating the breakdown of rocks and minerals. In order for the soil making party to really get going, the mixture of rock particles and organisms needs to stay in one spot for a long time. This is the importance of R, or relief. The steeper the slope, the more likely that soil will be eroded and not have the time it needs to mature. This leads to the final important factor, T, for time. Time controls all. Even with all the right ingredients, soil needs hundreds of years for the CLORPT processes to act.
Over time, the factors of CLORPT will come together to form a soil profile. This process is greatly simplified, and complexities do exist, resulting in dozens of different soil types, some of which are listed here. And now it's time to ask the big question.
Why is this simple story of CLORPT important? Well, the truth of the matter is, humans are making a lasting mark on soil, just like it is made on our new sneakers.
Construction, climate change, poor agricultural practices, dams, and water misuse, all of these and more are causing problems for soil and interrupting CLORPT. As funny as it may seem, we need to think more about the dull soil that feeds us and nurtures our environment if we are to enjoy a brighter future.